Spacetime and Principles of the Theory of Relativity. In the general theory of relativity, events are represented as points in a four-dimensional manifold in the context of spacetime. Here, Euclidean metrics for distance are inadequate. Instead, the spacetime interval between two events is used, which includes both spatial and temporal components. Minkowski metric. In a flat Minkowski space, the spacetime interval measures the distance between two events in spacetime. This interval combines both spatial and temporal distances in a way that is invariant or invariant under transformations. The spacetime interval includes the differences in time and space coordinates between events and provides light speed invariance. This invariance is critical because it is consistent with the principle that the laws of physics, including the speed of light, remain consistent in all inertial reference frames. When changing from one coordinate system to another, such as from one set of space and time coordinates to another, the form of the space-time interval must be preserved. This requirement is very important in the theory of relativity and is achieved by Lorentz transformations. These transformations adjust the space and time coordinates so that the space-time interval remains constant. This constancy forms the basis of the principle of relativity, which states that the laws of physics are the same in all inertial frames. Tensor notation in spacetime. To simplify the representation of spacetime intervals, physicists use tensor algebra. Here, coordinates are represented by superscripts representing time and the three spatial dimensions. To simplify the expression of spacetime intervals, a four-row, four-column matrix called the metric tensor is introduced. This tensor helps manage the combination of spatial and temporal components and ensures that the interval remains invariant. The metric tensor operates on its indices, allowing for efficient computation of invariant quantities in spacetime. The Minkowski metric and Lorentz transformations form the backbone of special relativity, ensuring the consistency of the laws of physics across different inertial frames. The metric tensor plays a fundamental role in describing the geometry of spacetime and allows physicists to generalize the concepts of distance to four-dimensional spacetime. This distinction between spatial and temporal components is crucial for understanding relativistic effects such as time dilation and length contraction that arise from the invariant nature of spacetime intervals. In advanced physics, the concept of the metric tensor extends to general relativity, where it varies from point to point and describes the curvature of spacetime created by mass and energy. This change continues with the replacement of the simple form of the Minkowski metric with a more general tensor that takes into account gravitational effects. While the Minkowski metric and its tensor representation provide powerful frameworks for understanding spacetime in special relativity, new difficulties arise in computations over these tensors in the transition to general relativity. The general metric tensor describes curved spacetime. Also, although the tensor representation is compact and elegant, it can be abstract and difficult to grasp without a solid understanding of differential geometry. Lorentz transformations. Transformations that preserve the Minkowski metric are known as Lorentz transformations, which form a group under matrix multiplication. Extending the Lorentz transformations leads to the more general Poincaré group, which includes the symmetries of spacetime in special relativity. This discussion emphasizes the interconnectedness of geometric transformations, the structure of spacetime, and physical phenomena such as gravity within the framework of general relativity. The mathematical rigor involved in defining these relationships is crucial for a deeper understanding of the structure of the universe. This extended discussion examines the relationships between acceleration, coordinate systems, and the geometric framework of general relativity, and emphasizes the use of tensor calculus to manage coordinate transformations and the necessity of understanding the structural nature of spacetime. Instantaneous velocity and local inertial frames. Consider an accelerating particle. By continuously decreasing the duration of the time intervals, we approach the limit where these intervals approach zero. At this limit, the difference in speed between the endpoints of each interval decreases, giving rise to the instantaneous speed. At this point, the speed becomes constant and the particle behaves for a moment as if it were in an inertial frame. At this moment, all the results from the special theory of relativity can be applied, assuming that the particle is instantaneously inert. Locally inertial frames in a gravitational field. In general relativity, it is assumed that at any point in space-time subject to a gravitational field, it is possible to choose a locally inertial coordinate system. In an infinitesimally small region around any point, the laws of physics take the same form as they do in an inertial Cartesian coordinate system. This principle is crucial to understanding that observers in free fall in a gravitational field do not feel the forces of gravity. Locally, the laws of physics reduce to those found in non-gravitational contexts. Variable velocities and tensor calculus. An accelerating object experiences a different velocity at each instant, requiring a unique coordinate system for each instant. Einstein tensors are used to manage the complexities of transitioning from one system to another. These tensors are mathematical entities that remain invariant under coordinate transformations, making them ideal for describing the laws of physics in coordinate systems that vary across space-time. Constructing a geometric framework set. The most basic concept in constructing a geometric framework is a set, which is a collection of distinct objects considered as an entity. This is the building block for more complex structures. Topological space. A topological space is constructed by defining a set with a topology, which is a collection of open sets that satisfy certain axioms. This framework allows the definition of continuous functions, limits, and convergence, which are necessary for analyzing the properties of spaces. Manifold. A manifold is a topological space that is locally similar to Euclidean space. Every point in a manifold has a region that is homeomorphic to an open subset of Euclidean space, which makes it possible to apply calculus to these spaces. Connected manifold. A connected manifold is a manifold that is connected, meaning that there is a path between any two points in the manifold. This ensures that the manifold is a single piece and not made up of disjoint pieces. Riemannian multiplet. A Riemannian multiplet is a connected multiplet equipped with a Riemannian metric that allows the measurement of lengths and angles. This metric is a positive definite quadratic form that varies smoothly in tangent space at every point, facilitating the application of geometric and analytical techniques. Constructing a Riemannian manifold. Consider a set M and equip it with a topological structure, then approximate it locally as a Euclidean space so that M becomes a manifold. We can transform this manifold into a Riemannian manifold by defining a connection and a metric on it. In this manifold, Euclidean coordinate systems can be connected at every point, and smooth transformations can be performed between them. Einstein field equations. This discussion covers the theoretical foundations and mathematical frameworks necessary to understand and apply the principles of general relativity. By integrating tensor calculus with differential geometry, Einstein provided deep insight into the workings of the universe and how gravity arises from the curvature of space-time. This analysis requires a foundation in theoretical physics and advanced mathematical concepts that aim to provide a comprehensive understanding of the structural and dynamical aspects of space-time as described by general relativity. The Einstein field equations are the cornerstone of general relativity. It describes how matter and energy affect the curvature of space-time. The equations relate the geometric properties of space-time encoded in the Einstein tensor to the energy and momentum contained in space-time, represented by the stress-energy tensor. The Einstein tensor encompasses the curvature of space-time and is derived from the Ricci curvature tensor and the metric tensor. The stress-energy tensor describes the density and flow of energy and momentum in space-time. Together, these tensors come from the Einstein field equations and are expressed as the Einstein tensor is equal to the stress-energy tensor. These equations capture the complex interactions between matter, energy, and the curvature of spacetime. They explain how the presence of matter and energy distorts the fabric of spacetime and gives rise to the gravitational effects observed in the universe. Solutions to these equations provide insights into a wide range of phenomena, from the bending of light by gravity to the dynamics of black holes to the expansion of the universe. Thank you for listening. Stay well.